Hi everyone, I'm Ian Harvey, this is my friend Jen. That's it. Today, we're going to be talking about how I do my just general neck work. I'm not going to be working with any particular areas of pain. I'm just going to be doing my general warm-up slash routine. So if the person doesn't have any specific complaints and I want to work on the neck, this is about what it looks like. As always, I'm coming at things from a myofascial perspective, but I do have a significant amount of oil on my hands, so I've got a good amount of glide. I'm not going excruciatingly slowly like I would with certain pain conditions. If I did need to get specific after this, in about 5 minutes, most of this jojoba is going to be absorbed, so you can then transition to that slower work. So my general opening stroke is going to be smoothing this anterior fascia below the clavicles and scooping up into the lateral and posterior neck, finally ending up in the occiput. And even traveling up into the hairline. Jen, do you mind if I mess up your hair a bit?
Nope, go for it.
All right. So, when you're thinking myofascially, there's a lot of nice, thick, white fascia up into the scalp. So don't ignore that. I'm outlining the clavicles here with my fingertips and thumbs. I'm outlining the head of the humerus with my fingertips and thumbs. And then I'm scooping this fascia. What if your fingers don't bend this way? That's something that I've gotten asked by several of my students, because I've got hyperextensible metacarpophalangeal joints. Well, first thing, they didn't always. So after a few years of stretching, you may be able to do this, but if not, just stay with what you're able to do. I can dodge behind the shoulders like this and not have to come into that extreme hyperextension. I'm using my fingertips as I come up into this occipital ridge. Yeah, the occipital region can take a good amount of specific pressure. And then I'm going to do some alternating kneading. I'm using a duck grip for this. Quack, quack. I'm not using a sharp pincer grip. And that's so that I can grab these sheets of fascia rather than pinpointing any particular areas. Then I'm transitioning into fingertips once again as I come up into the neck. So I've done some of those swoops. Each time I define a bit of the anatomy, I've done alternating kneading, and now I'm going to start mobilizing this neck. So I'm shoving southward as my other hand draws upward and inward. So as one hand shoves inferiorly and laterally, the other hand comes up medially and superiorly. And that creates this nice rocking motion. One, this gets people out of their pattern of holding their neck for you. And two, it's an easy way of getting their head over to one side so that now I can work just on this right side if I felt like doing that right now. But I'm going to show you another way of turning the neck. Instead, I'm going to come into another one of those nice swoops. Next up, I'm going to walk underneath the thoracic spine. To do that, I'm going to use this tool. And these knuckles, my punching knuckles, my metacarpophalangeal joints, are going to be a lever, like this. Is that visible? Yeah, it is. Okay, so each side is going to be And Jen, see if you can allow your shoulders to be as heavy as possible.
Oh.
Yes. So don't feel like you need to help with this. So I'm doing short little steps. I'm walking down her spine. And this part is part of the massage. This walking is. And then once I've gotten to a nice distance, maybe T6 or something like that, I'm going to drag toward myself. And because my table is so loud when I do this, I'm only doing it in short little jumps. And then allowing my fingers to travel further, and then resetting my hand, then allowing my fingers to travel further. If I had a fleece pad on this table, I could just lean back and allow my hands to flow upward. And then I'm continuing next to that spine. And that's where my fingers have been this entire time. I do this little crawl, waka waka walk, and then I kind of settle into those laminar grooves, and I come up northward. And I'm always either using these knuckles as a fulcrum, or my wrist as a fulcrum. I'm never just using my biceps. I'm never just using my forearm muscles. Instead, I set the angle of that lever, and then I change the angle of that lever. And that's much easier than using your muscles to change the angle here. Instead, I set that angle, and then I move my arm. Okay, pretty basic stuff. Now, I'd like to move her head over to the left. Jen, just let your head be as loosey-goosey as possible. And this is something that I've shown in other videos before. I call this the Harvey maneuver because I'm an egomaniac. Okay, so I'm setting the palmar surface of my hand on top of and just south of her clavicle. And my right hand, I'm using a soft fist. The palm goes laterally, the fist goes medially. And this, easy as can be, turns the head. If you find your client pushing back against that fist, just ask them to allow their neck to be as free as possible. If that doesn't work, just say, roll toward your left, and they'll do it, and it'll be fine. Some people cannot let go of their neck as hard as they try. We're very protective of our necks. So why am I doing this? One, I'm working with this fascia that lives up here because this fascia is directly connected to the position of the neck. As I press into this anterior chest fascia, it drags the neck and the head to the right. So imagine if this is tight on both sides. What's it doing to the neck? What's it doing to the head? It's yanking it forward. So if we can do a myofascial stretch here, we can hopefully loosen the connection. So now that I have gotten the head over to one side, I can start working unilaterally. So I'm just going to do some nice alternating Petrissage. My thumb is going to creep its way up next to this clavicle. And we're going to work on these scalenes just a bit. I'm not going to press in deeply, and the angle of my force is going to be down toward the table rather than down toward her first rib. But it'll still get those scalenes a bit in a way that shouldn't be too sensitive. Next up, I can do that walking maneuver again. Waka waka walk. This time, I'm outlining that scapula. Ooh, This hand isn't using a lot of pressure. It's just outlining that spine of the scapula while this hand comes up superior, comes up north. And now I'm going to work with trapezius and deltoid at the same time. Deltoid and trapezius are very tightly related myofascially. The thick white fascia that exists in the trapezius is continuous with the fascia in the deltoid. So I'm giving a nice little fascial stretch here. As these hands move in opposite directions. Next, I'm going to do some work that you saw in the stiff neck video. And I'm going to be applying pressure down onto the superior angle of the scapula. It'll feel like a little bony knob. And then I'm going to be traveling up right next to the spine. This is levator scapula, the number one muscle involved in neck cricks. And I'm slowly making my way up. I'm stopping occasionally. This is in its own way a kind of myofascial pin-in stretch. If I was dealing with an acute stiff neck, I would go more slowly, I'd be more sensitive, and I would ask about any intense sensation. But since this is just a general warm-up, I'm just flowing on up, getting all the way to the base of the skull, and then moving on. From here, I might move to this arm and work with this. I'll have another video on how I work with the hand and the forearm and the upper arm. But otherwise, I'll move back to some nice kneading work. I'll probably do another stroke up with my fingertips, kind of defining that medial border of the scapula. And then, when I want to straighten this neck back out, I'm going to use this. It's a secret technique. I'm going to take my fingertips and I'm going to curl them onto the opposite side of her spine. So I'm going past these spinous processes. I'm around C7, T1, and I'm pressing up toward the ceiling and pulling toward myself. And that kind of resets the head. You can promote it a bit with your other hand. And that's a nice stripping move to start working with this neck bilaterally again. I'll do another bilateral stroke or two, and then I'll move to the other side. I'll finish with a nice cranial cradle, and I'll probably throw some scalp work in here. And that is how I work with the neck. Leave me comments in the comment section. Consider subscribing, and I'll see you next time. Thank you.
Could have gone to sleep in that last part.